Hi there, today on Typical Books, I'm going to talk about new fiction coming out for October and a little in November. Now, of course, as I'd mentioned, there are so many books coming out in October. It's spooky season. It is the autumn. It is fall. It is October. It is definitely the month in which horror lives, if not the month in which horror is born. So many releases. There's so many coming out that the last few videos have been sort of coming out kind of rapidly. There was a little bit of a delay, so today I have 14 books to talk about, plus a little bit of a book that's already out right now. Local Haunts was released on October 1st, so that's really the first book I want to talk about today, although I have other videos and another coming up. So if you haven't seen it already, you can go and check out my video on the origins of my story, Fading Applause in Quintland, and I'm going to have another video coming up soon where I talk about each story in turn. A lot of the other contributors are doing giveaways as well, so you can go and check out some of their channels too, and like Regina's, Dane's, people are talking about doing giveaways, so for the next couple weeks I'm sure you'll find one or two giveaways to enter if you haven't picked up a copy already. Before I get into the new releases, a couple new books came my way via a thrift store. There's not much to choose from around here. In the area of town I live, it's awfully quiet, and there's not a lot of stores, really. So I had stopped by a Salvation Army, and I picked up this little cardigan that's sort of a lacy, frilly little thing with ruched sleeves. I really like it a lot. And I had chanced into a copy of Ender's Game by Orson Scott Card that my uncle has just finished reading for the umpteenth time. And he just loves this book, so I thought I'd check it out too. My uncle has got to be one of my number one reading influencers all of my life. So I'm going to definitely check this out since I haven't. And I don't know when I'm going to get to it because I've got a few other books to read first, like Wuthering Heights. This was another book I picked up, and I think I paid $3 for it. And it's a really lovely little hardbound collection from Laurel Press, it says, and just a beautiful little book. I would love to get some of the other Bronte sisters in the same collection if it exists. So yeah, that was a really cute little find and very inexpensive, and they had some Halloween things there too, so it was nice to just scope out some of the Halloween things. I picked up a little pumpkin candle holder as well. I do have a few pumpkin-y things in the house, I'm not gonna lie, and we do have year-round autumn decorations, so we don't just do this every year. Like many people who love horror and love Halloween and love fall, it is like sort of eternal autumn here. So we have a new addition to the crowd with this little candle holder. I really like it a lot, and I'm glad that I got out for a little jaunt to the thrift store. So speaking of autumn and spooky season, here are some new releases, one or two for November, but the rest all coming up this month in October from Horror Writers Association authors. Okay, there's quite a few to get through. 14 books, if my count is correct. And the first one, The Spirits Talk to Me, is coming out from Hachette, India, and it kind of marks something interesting. It's the beginning of the Horror Writers Association India chapter, and it's spearheaded by Neil De Silva, who is one of the authors here, or editors. It is a book that recounts 10 of the most unsettling investigations that the team of Parapsychology and Investigations Research Society, or PAIRS, conducted in haunted locations in India. This is co-authored by paranormal investigator Sarbajeet, Mohanty, and Neil De Silva. These are real stories of paranormal investigations, and I think that it's a cool flagship book that they can celebrate at HWA India, so welcome to the HWA, and I'm looking forward to more. We also have had, like as far as India news, a lot more horror podcasts being available in India, so there's a burgeoning, and if you've been into indie and international film here, there is a huge market for horror in India and a huge creator space for horror in India. So very exciting stuff. A Season of Whispers by Jackson Kuhl. This comes from Aurelia Leo, and it is coming out now. In the summer of 1844, Tom Lemon flees to Bonaventure, a transcendentalist farming cooperative tucked away in eastern Connecticut. But Bonaventure isn't as utopian as it seems. Lyman must discover the truth before he's driven mad by the whispering through the walls. And coming up soon, The Bone Carver by Monique Snyman. This comes from Vesuvian Books. In the follow-up to The Night Weaver, Rachel Cleary continues to come into her powers as she maintains a desire to leave the town that keeps drawing her back into a dangerous mystery. After more encounters with the Fae, unwanted gifts, and a spate of incidents eventually turn up a body. How can she flee the town when it needs her help to survive? That is The Bone Carver. And here is Cursed by Richard Schiver. And there's a lot of really cool covers. Like, I'm not going to comment on every single one because you can see for yourself how cool they are. But some of these just, oh man. This comes from Abiss Books and it is coming on the 20th. After the loss of her husband, Susan sought a safe place to rebuild a life for herself and her six-year-old daughter, Christine. Quaint and picturesque, Porter Mine seemed ideal. Susan soon learns appearances can be deceiving. Doesn't say much, but the title alone, Cursed, you know, it conjures up something in my mind. So does this title, Greyfriars Reformatory by Frazer Lee. This comes from Flame Tree Press. 19-year-old Emily's acute dissociative disorder causes her to be institutionalized again at Greyfriars Reformatory for Girls. When the terrifying apparition of the mysterious Grey Girl begins scaring the inmates to death, Emily's disorder may be one thing that can save her. I love these spins on mental illness being the powerful tool that people are using for survival. And coming on the 27th, The Curse of the Mountain by Tyler Cram, another really cool cover. While on a hike in the North Carolina wilderness, four friends discover an old book. When they open it, they black out, only to find on waking they have released the evil things that live within the pages. That sounds familiar. The Seeking by Marlena Frank. This comes from Parliament House Press and is out on the 27th as well. Every child of the priest family must avoid capture for the full day of the Seeking. When things go wrong with the renewal, they must learn who would require such a cruel game every year and if the protection of the Grey People is really worth such a price. Now, The Empty Space is a Kate Pomeroy mystery by Linda Watkins and comes out from Argon Press. Three shots from a sniper's rifle send Kate Pomeroy's world spiraling into a deadly tailspin. Worried about the safety of those she loves, she sets out on a dangerous journey to bring an obsessive man to justice. Will she fall prey to the psychopath who wishes to once again enslave her? This one was actually released in May, but is hitting the release late. 9-star Blues, Stories from an Ancient Future. Rooted in rhythm, threaded with magic, this debut fiction collection encompasses worlds that begin within river bottoms, pass through spectral gates, and end in distant, uncharted worlds. The stories collected in 9-bar blues weave emotion, spirit, and music, captivating readers with newfound alchemy and the murmurs of dark gods. I like that cover too. This is a cover I can get behind too, and this particular book you will be hearing more about soon, Slay, Stories of the Vampire Noir by Nicole Givens-Kurtz, edited by that is, from Mocha Memoirs Press. Drawing from a variety of cultural and mythological backgrounds, we imagine a world of horror and wonder where black protagonists take center stage as vampires, as hunters, as heroes. From immortal deities to resistance fighters, matriarchal vampire broods to monster-hunting fathers, coming-of-age stories to end-of-life stories, Slay is a vampire anthology celebrating the rich cultural heritage of the African diaspora. So very looking forward to that. I had a preview copy that I just haven't got to yet because I got into Mina's Child first and then reading Local Haunts, of course, again. So that is coming up next. And I just love the cover of this and very excited to read some vampire shorts to go along with the very literary fiction of Mina's Child. I think that's a fantastic juxtaposition there. Now coming from McFarlane Press by James Goho, it is Caitlin R. Kiernan, A Critical Study of Her Dark Fiction. I hope no one does a critical study of my fiction ever. Thank you. This book is already out. Caitlin R. Kiernan, A Critical Study of Her Dark Fiction, is the first full-length book on Kiernan's work. The book explores her fictional universe through several critical literary lenses to show the scope of her contributions to modern gothic and dark fantasy literature. So a must-read for fans of Caitlin R. Kiernan or those looking to expand their horizons when it comes to weird fiction. Coming soon, Downwind, Alice by C.C. Adams, LVP Publications. Seems I've had a C.C. Adams book in the releases every video or two, isn't it? Alice has no idea what's coming to her. By the time she does, it will be too late. After 2 years away, a chance encounter proves awkward and sours when Alice lashes out before storming off. An unfortunate turn of events that would soon blow over, right? Wrong. A fascinating kind of turn there that doesn't tell you much about what the story is about, but the name Downwind Alice definitely leads me to believe she's being hunted. The Realm by L. Murray Wood. This comes from Cedar Grove Publishing and is out at the end of the month. Patrick closes his eyes to the only life he's ever known and opens them to a new and dangerous world. In this realm, the newly dead from all over the universe are being hunted, and he must fight to save the living world as well as what comes after. And finally, this one's coming out in November, so I may revisit it. Who knows? Because it looks very interesting to me. I just love the cover. And I like the story. Those who have just read or had tuned in on my review of Devil's Creek by Todd Kiesling may understand why I think this is so fascinating. And those who chimed in with how much they love reading about cults and stuff like that may enjoy this one too. The Children of Red Peak by Craig DeLuey. This comes from Red Hook, which is an imprint of Hachette, and it comes out, like I said, near the mid-November. The survivors of a doomsday cult's horrific last days reunite to confront their past and the entity that appeared on the final night. Answers lie buried at Red Peak. But truth has a price, and escaping a second time may demand the ultimate sacrifice. That is books coming out in October and one in November. Quite a few that are already out now or out like today. So I hope you enjoyed that massive list. There's probably going to be another one coming up, but not as girthy before Halloween, because I want to be squeezing in any late arrivals before that ultimate day, right? So you can feather your nest of books, as it were, if you're like a dragon sleeping on a pile of money when it comes to a TBR pile like I am. And of course, if you are interested in any of these books, let me know in the comments or if you've read them already. My review of Slay will be coming up soon. I'm very excited to talk about that particular book. As far as vampire fiction, vampire shorts, and black vampires, very excited. And I'm also very excited to hear what people have to say about local haunts. There have been some reviews coming out. There's been a lot of videos of people talking about it and just the appreciation out there. I know that other authors have already said their thank yous. I keep saying thank you, and I'm going to keep saying thank you. So if you have any questions about local haunts, definitely let me know. And there will be another video on that coming out soon too. As ever, let me know what you're reading in the comments below, or if there's anything that you think I ought to be reading. Thank you so much for watching, and have an ooky, spooky day.